ஸ்ரீ குருபியோ நம சில்ட்ரன், வெல்கம் டு ஆன்லைன் கிளாஸ்.
எக்ஸசைஸ் 1.3 ஃபர்ஸ்ட் க்வெஸ்சன். ரைட் த ஃபாலோயிங் இன் டெசிமல் ஃபார்ம் அண்ட் சி வாட் கைண்ட் ஆஃப் டெசிமல் எக்ஸ்பான்ஷன் ஈச் ஹேஸ். ஃபர்ஸ்ட் க்வெஸ்சன், 36/100. ஃபர்ஸ்ட் யூ ஹாவ் டு கன்வெர்ட் இட் இன்டு டெசிமல் எக்ஸ்பான்ஷன். ஸோ 36/100. So 0.0, 3 × 100, 300. So remaining 60. One more zero here, 6 × 100, 600. So what's the decimal expansion of this number? 0.36. What is the remainder here? Remainder 0. If you are getting remainder 0, the decimal expansion is a terminating function. The decimal expansion has terminating . Second question, 4 × 1/8. This is a mixed fraction. First you have to convert it into improper fractions. 4 × 8 + 1. 4 × 8 are 32, 32 + 1, 33/8. Now I have to convert it into a decimal expansion. So 33/8. 4 × 8 are 32. Remaining 1. Put point, add 1, 0. 1 × 8 are 8. Remaining 2, 0. 2 × 8 are 16. Remaining 4, 0. 5 × 8 are 40. So here, what is the remainder here? 0. First, we write the decimal expansion, 4.125. Now, I got the decimal expansion. Then, at the same time, remainder is also 0. Therefore, the decimal expansion as terminating. Next question, third one, 2/11. 2/11. First we have to convert it into a decimal expansion. Then we have to find out which type of decimal expansion. So 2/11, 0. Here 0. How many times will come? 1 × 11 are 11. Remaining 9. One more 0 here. 8 × 11 are 88. Remaining 1, sorry, remaining 2, then 1 more 0, 1 × 11 are 11, remaining 9, add 0, 8 × 11 are 88, here again 2. So now you check 0.1818. So at the same time, I am not getting the remainder 0 also. First you write the decimal expansion, 0.1818 up to etc. So here remainder is not equal to 0. At the same time, repetition is coming. It can be written as 0.18 bar. Therefore, the decimal expansion as non-terminating repeating. The decimal expansion has non-terminating. Non-terminating repeating. See, 0.1818, the repetition is coming. At the same time, remainder is not equal to 0. Therefore, the decimal expansion has non-terminating repeating. Next question, fourth one. 329/400. First, you will have to convert it into decimal expansion. 329/400. So 0.0. So 8 times. 8 × 400, 3200. So remaining 90, if I add one more 0, 900. If I take 2 times, 2 × 400, 800. Remaining 100. So one more 0 you add, 1000 is coming. Again, 2 times 2 into 400 800 remaining 00 200 and one more 0 5 times 5 into 400 2000 See now I got the remainder is 0 What the decimal expansion of this one 0.8225 So I got 0.822 is a decimal expansion and the same time remainder is also 0 Therefore the decimal expansion as terminating Question number 2. You know that 1 by 7 equal to 0.142857. Can you predict that what the decimal expansion of 2 by 7, 3 by 7, 4 by 7, 5 by 7, 6 by 7 are without actually doing the long division? If so, how? Yes, I can predict the decimal expansion of the given questions. So what is given here 1 by 7 equal to 0.142857 bar. So how am I going to find out 2 by 7, 3 by 7, 4 by 7, etc. So 2 by 7, it can be written as 2 into 1 by 7. I know the value of 1 by 7 that is given. So 2 into 0.142857 bar. Just you have to multiply the number into 2. 2 sevens are 14, remaining 1. 5 twos are 10. 10 plus 1, 11. The remaining 1. 8 twos are 16. 16 plus 1, 17. Remaining 1. 2 twos are 4 plus 1, 5. 4 twos are 8. 1 twos are 2. So 0.28571 bar. Next one, 3 by 7. 3 by 7 can be written as 3 into 1 by 7, which is equal to 3 into 0.142857 bar is given. We have to multiply this number by 3. So next to multiply, 3 sevens are 21, remaining 2, 5 threes are 15, 15 plus 2 17, remaining 1, 8 threes are 24, 24 plus 1 25, remaining 2, 2 threes are 6, 6 plus 2 8, 4 threes are 12, remaining 1, 1 threes are 3, 3 plus 1, 4. So 0.428571. bar. Next one, 4 by 7. 4 by 7 can be written as 4 into 1 by 7. This is equal to 4 into 0.142857 bar. I have to multiply the number by 4 table. 4 sevens are 28, remaining 2. Next one, 4 5s are 20, 20 plus 2, 22, remaining 2, 4 8s are 32, 32 plus 2, 34, remaining 3, 4 2s are 8, 8 plus 3, 11, remaining 1, 4 4s are 16, 16 plus 1, 17, remaining 1, 1 4s are 4, 4 plus 1, 5. Bar. Next one, 5 by 7. 5 by 7 can be written as 5 into 1 by 7, which is equal to 5 into 0.142857 bar. Next you multiply by 5, 7 5s are 35, remaining 3, 5 5s are 25, 25 plus 3, 28, remaining 2, 8 5s are 40, 40 plus 2, 42, remaining 4, 5 2s are 10, 10 plus 4, 14, remaining 1, 4 5s are 20, 20 plus 1, 21, remaining 2, then 1 5s are 5, 5 plus 2, 7, 0.7 7, 1, 2, 8, 5 bar. The last one is 6 by 7. Can be written as 6 into 1 by 7. Therefore, 6 into 0.142857 bar. We have to multiply by 6. 6 into 7, 42. Remaining 4. 6 by 7, 30. 30 plus 4, 34. Remaining 2. 6 8s are 48. 48 plus 3. 51. Remaining 5. 6 2s are 12. 12 plus 5, 17. Remaining 1. 6 4s are 24. 24 plus 1, 25. Remaining 2. 1 6 are 6. 6 plus 2, 8. 0.857142 bar. I can predict the values of the given questions. Question number 3. Express the following in the form of P by Q, where P and Q are integers, Q not equal to 0. But the first solution is given 0.6 bar. What type of decimal expansion? This decimal expansion has non-terminating repeating. So we have to express in the form of P by Q. First I am going to take, let x is equal to 0.6 bar. Then x is equal to 0.6 bar means the 6 repeatedly is coming up to etc. I am going to take, this is equation 1. So after 1's place, since 1 digit only is repeated, so I am going to multiply 10 on both sides. If 2 bar is there, means you have to multiply by 100, 3 means 1000. So 10 into x, 10 lakhs equal to 0.666 up to etc. into 10. That is equal to for 6.6666 up to etc. So 10 lakhs equal to 6.666 up to etc. This is equation 2. Now I am going to subtract 2 minus 1. What is second equation? 10x is equal to 6.666 up to etc. This equation 1, x is equal to 0.666 up to etc. Now I am going to subtract the terms. So here 6 minus 0. See, everything will cancel. So 6 minus 0, 6 equal to 10x minus x, 9x. So x is equal to 6 by 9. So I can cancel by 3 table, 2 times 3 times. Therefore x is equal to 2 by 3. Now I got P by Q form, where P is equal to 2, Q is equal to 3. Then Q is not equal to 0, 3 is not equal to 0. Next one, 0.47 bar. Second subdivision, 0.47 bar. See how I am going to write, let x is equal to 0.47 bar. So what is the meaning for this one? After decimal, only 7 only is repeated. So x is equal to 0.4777 up to etc. That is, I am going to take, this is equation 1. See, so here is also 1 digits only is repeated. So I am going to multiply 10 on both sides. So 10 into x, 10x equal to 0.4777 up to etc. into 10. If I multiply 0.4777 up to etc., I will get 4.7777 up to etc. So this is equation 2. So I am going to subtract equation 2 minus 1. What is equation 2? 10x equal to 4.777 up to etc. What is equation 1? X is equal to 0.4777 up to etc. I'm going to subtract minus. So 10x minus x, 9x equal to, here now we check 7 minus 7, 0, 7 minus 7, 0, 7 minus 0. So everything will cancel. Here 7 minus 4, that is equal to 4, 3. Here decimal is there, put decimal. 4 minus 0, 4. So x is equal to 4.3 by 9. But question, what question they are? Find the express in the form of P by Q. So here 4.3 is that. So I have to convert it into a whole number. So I am going to multiply 10, the numerator and denominator. So 43 by 90 is coming. Now I got P by Q form. Therefore x is equal to 43 by 90. Where P is equal to 43, Q is equal to 90. At the same time Q is not equal to 0. 90 is not equal to 0. Sum number 7. Write 3 numbers whose decimal expressions are non-terminating, non-recurring. They ask 3 numbers with decimal expression. At the same time, non-terminating, non-recurring. What is meant by non-terminating? Remainder 0 will not come. Non-recurring means repetition also will not come. Non-repeating. Repetition also will not come. So they ask 3 examples. The first one, at the same time we have to give in a decimal expression. 0.01, 0.01, 0.001, 0.0001, 0.0001 up to etc. See here, this is the one of the examples. So decimal expansion is there. Repetition is also not there. At the same time, I am not getting the remainder 0 also. Another example, 0.200, 2000, 2000, 2000, up to etc. You can take any number without repetation. 5.4321567841209 up to etc. No repetition is there. Then at the same time remainder is also not equal to 0. Question number 9. Classify numbers as the following as rational or irrational. So we have to classify the given number as a rational or irrational. First one, square root of 23. Square, if you are converting into a decimal expansion, we will get non-terminating, non-recurring form. So, non-terminating, non-recurring means it is a irrational number. Therefore, square root of 23 is a irrational number. Irrational number. Second one, square root of 225. So, this is a perfect square because we know that value 15 into 15 is 225. Square root of 15 into 15, that is equal to 15. 15 is a rational number because it can be written as 15 by 1, which is equal to rational number. Rational number. Next, third one, 0.3796. 0.3796. So this is a decimal expansion. It can be written as 3796 by 10,000. So it is a rational number because it is in the form of P by Q. So it is a rational number. Next, fourth one, 7.47878 up to etc. So first we have to find out if the decimal expansion is a terminating or non-terminating. So 7.47878. So what are the up to etc. is there? What is the repetition here? 7878. So it can be written as 7.478 bar. So if repetition is there, it is a rational number. Therefore, 7.478 up to etc. is a rational number. Next, fifth one. What the question is given? 1.10, 1.100, 1.000, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 1.100, 0. It is a non-terminating round occurring means it is an irrational number. It is an irrational number.